one thing you mentioned that people think that digital is cheaper. Digital is just about Facebook posts and all that stuff.
Yeah.
But you think digital is not cheaper, but it's costlier effort.
Very complicated. I'll tell you the reason people think it is cheaper. Everybody have a Facebook.
Yeah.
Everybody sees in a Facebook, it says, if you post with 100,000 rupees, I will make this post visible to 1 lakh people. Everybody think, oh, it's so cheap. 1,000 rupees click and 1 lakh people will see my content. So this has created the problem.
Yeah.
So people think with 1,000 rupees you can reach. It is so cheaper. Facebook digital is quite complicated. It is very costly. Yes. Compared to traditional, it is cheaper. But it is not cheap. It is not a cheap alternative. It is one way of reducing your cost. But it is definitely cost. See, I'll tell you, very simple. If you take one hotel, same thing which you asked. If you take a hotel, hotel will cost you 5 lakhs. But you will not know where the 5 lakhs gone. But if you spend the same 5 lakhs on digital, you will exactly know where that each area is gone.
Yeah.
So it is efficient.
Yeah.
So that answers solved. If you want to put an ad in a front page of a newspaper, it will cost you 10 lakhs or even a crore for all services. But with 1 crore, you can talk to the entire country for 1 year.
So I assume that is what you meant when you say there's a lot of myth about digital, since they do not understand that it is costly, etc.
So when a customer comes to you and then it asks you that this is my business, now how are you supposed to? And that person already has a picture in his mind that digital is all about Facebook, Instagram and all that stuff.
Yeah.
Then how do you break out that person?
Very interesting. I figure out this is a problem which I'll face with everybody who don't understand. First, I take a paid session with a client. You have to pay me 3 lakh rupees, listen and understand what is digital. So that while I'm working, you will not disturb me with stupid questions.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
First I teach them, they understand, then we work.
Okay.
Otherwise, he's going to question me every time.
Yeah.
Acha, my son knows this, it's so easy. My daughter can also do this. You know, my cousin is a Google expert, it's so easy. So I break that with the help of my training session. So training for the people who understand, then I'll work.
So this is how you proceed. Like first is the training session, and if that person, like then to that person has mostly hired you, then you'll continue with the process that it is.
Also earlier you mentioned that when businesses come to you, you reject a lot of them. So on what basis do you select them? What is your main criteria that you see?
First thing, do they really value digital marketing? People think I understand it, I understand.
Yeah.
Second. They only come for lead. KP business, I don't know. It doesn't work. Because they think from tomorrow the leads will start coming. It doesn't work. There's a school who have hired me. Can you get me students? Yes. The doctor who have hired me, can you get me patient? Yes. All those things I don't work.
And you state that knowledge is the biggest challenge and the biggest problem of a society or a business.
Yeah.
So what is that knowledge and why would you say decision maker is in the lowest level of knowledge?
Half-baked knowledge is killing the environment. Just because digital is new, everybody have a myth. They read 2 blogs, 5 videos, 6 content, 3 things, and they feel that they have understood digital. So half-baked is quite a problem. It's very difficult to teach someone digital and work with someone digital.
Yeah, it
takes time to
find them and then...
Very, very point. So that's the reason I look for empty people who have no idea on digital. And I teach them. That's how it works. Same thing with client.
This is the issue of the odd thing most of the people who do not understand. They will say 15, 20, 1 lakh. You know digital school like everybody. There's Times of India has called... which has calls this digital. Everybody...
I think I got it.
I have done the advanced level and I have done the course advanced level pro learn and internet of dash, which was not very audible, and virtuality.
Right. So I'll tell you.
Internet of things?
I got it. I think something is not correct. There are so many courses has come up.
Yeah.
20,000 rupees course, 30,000 rupees course, 10,000 rupees course. Today morning I was talking to someone, 1 lakh rupees course. This business, this become a huge industry because there are a lot of demand for this digital skill. who, where will you get the skill you need to teach people?
Yeah.
So let's have lots of business and people will come. So I've done the entire content for Prola. So on artificial intelligence, on data, on big data and all the stuff. But there's a huge dearth of knowledge. So all the mushrooms of companies are coming out. Even Times of India have their own digital school, Digital Vidya,
yeah.
Upgrade, you name it, ProLearn, a lot of IIMs are starting, Bitspilani, Manipal, 100. If you Google digital courses, you will find 20 people are coming and it will grow. And now there are individual people also coming with courses. I will teach course on 5,000 rupees, 3 days workshop,
yeah.
Right? So it is happening. It is happening because people want to know. Because people want to get ready. But the question is that to teach someone digital, it takes minimum of 3 years full time. It is so complicated and so large. Just doing one course will not work. If you want to be a overall digital understanding, if you want to do SEO, if you want to do a little bit of design, other part. But it's a deeper science, it's a deeper knowledge.